Hello, my name is Simon Beams, and I work in outdoor learning at the School of Education at the University of Edinburgh. Over the last couple of decades, outdoor learning has become a very broad church. It encompasses everything from curricular learning that takes place just outside the classroom to expeditions in faraway places, and everything in between, such as visits to farms, factories, museums, and government offices. In this video, I'm talking about the kind of outdoor learning that is cross-curricular and which occurs just outside the classroom. This might be in the school grounds or in local surroundings, but normally somewhere within walking distance. The benefits of this kind of outdoor teaching are that it is low cost and it can be done regularly. But why would a teacher want to teach outside in the first place? One key feature of learning outside the classroom is that it takes place in authentic learning contexts. We'll call it authenticity for short. Authenticity in education refers largely to whatever is being taught having a high degree of relevance to the student. This means keeping the sites for learning as real as possible, keeping them authentic. Authentic experiences are ones that have deep relevance for the learners and to their current lives, as opposed to many classroom sessions that are often about teaching concepts that may be very abstract and not directly linked to what is important to students. And it may be some kind of preparation for what they might do in the future, or it might not be. Effective learning outside the classroom focuses on topics that are contextualized within local phenomena, real things that are happening in people's everyday lives. Literature from place and community-based education tells us that this kind of learning can take place through environmental conservation, culture and the arts, businesses and other organizations, and through community service. All landscape, whether it's indoors or outdoors, near or far away, has an inherent interdisciplinary curriculum. And this can be revealed, this being the curriculum, can be revealed by teachers and students asking the question, what can be learned here? An example of this would be if a teacher and a class wanted to learn about biodiversity. A good starting point would be to determine a way to map the biodiversity that exists in their school grounds, or even in a small corner of their school grounds. And something as simple as this can be a very straightforward, concrete, and meaningful way into a very complex subject. You'll have probably found that even though I've been talking about learning outside the classroom, this is really a much more integrated indoor and outdoor approach to teaching. You can think of your walls or the walls of the classroom as being permeable, and it's your job as an educator to make a judgment on what is the most appropriate setting for the learning that you're trying to elicit, whether it's indoors or outdoors, in front of a computer screen or in an urban center or in a park or what have you. Ultimately, though, this is not about the outdoors and outdoor learning. This is about learning in authentic contexts that are real and have deep meaning for the students. John Dewey said more than 100 years ago that education is a process of living and not a preparation for future living. So let's make our education in the here and now and something that has deep relevance for students and their daily lives.